My previous video, I talked about the symptoms of estrogen excess, but I didn't talk about why these things happen. And I think it's very important for folks to understand why, because there are many things we can do to help us manage our estrogen levels better, especially when we're on a roller coaster in the perimenopause phase of our life. Now, if we're in menopause and we're supplementing with estrogens, this can be another factor, and you could be taking too much, and we'll talk about that here in a second. So taking too much estrogen, that would cause you to elevate your estrogen levels, but a lot of us don't even realize that we're taking in too much estrogen. Why? Because we're drinking our venti lattes out of a plastic lid cup. Hot plastic is xenoestrogens. That is a fake estrogen that gets in the system and causes a whole bunch of trouble. Where else can you get xenoestrogens? Well, in any time you go to the dry cleaner that's not a clean dry cleaner, meaning a green clean dry cleaner. The other big factor is plastics that are in your food. Are you microwaving in plastic? Are you heating up your burrito at work or your lean cuisine meal in the microwave? You're heating plastic, folks. That creates fake estrogens that helps that roller coaster keep going. Another place we can get it is if we are cooking nice, healthy meals at home, but we're using plastic utensils like spatulas and spoons. Big deal here. Pay attention to this. Same thing goes if you're still using fry pans that are scratched. Not bueno in this department, because you could be adding fake estrogens to your body whether you like it or not. So you really want to be thinking about what's going on in your environment that could be contributing to estrogens. Obviously, if you're supplementing with the bioidentical hormone, or your doc gave you a Vivel dot or one of the patches, a dotty patch or something of that nature, if you're noticing symptoms of estrogen excess, like I mentioned in my previous video, you're getting too much estrogen. You need to look back at, okay, what is happening? Why? Another factor here is impaired estrogen metabolism. Best way to know how you metabolize estrogens, you want to look at the Dutch test. It's a dried urine test that tells you how you break down your hormones. Everybody should be looking at this 3 months into supplementing with hormones, no matter what, to know what is happening on this level. Because if you're supplementing estrogens, but you're not doing well in that department, you could be building up estrone, which is this guy, the inflammatory estrogen, which usually causes the majority of those not so pleasant estrogen symptoms. The other big thing, decreased exercise. If you're not moving at least 5 days a week to get your heart rate up, double your baseline heart rate, you're not exercising. So what do you do before you get out of bed? Get your heart rate. Take a look at it. You can see what is going on your baseline. So that's your before you do anything, heart rate. Then double that number, make sure you're hitting that target every time you get out and move. 5 days a week, 30 minutes, you will start to see changes in your estrogen metabolism. Next thing, low fiber and low grain intake. With the whole concept of keto and low carb and all of these factors, a lot of us are forgetting that we need some fiber. A lot of folks are not eating enough vegetables. You need at least 6 cups of veggies a day, no matter what, to help you with your fiber intake. In terms of grains, sprouted grains, ancient grains like millet, quinoa, those kind of things can help you go a long way to get your fiber needs covered so that you can grab that estrogen from the gut and get it out of the system. If you're not so into taking in any more grains and you want to stay on a lower carb diet, you need something like calcium D glucarate. This is a supplement that pulls excessive estrogen out of your intestines. The other way to pull the excessive estrogen out of the body is something called diindole methane. This is a extract from cabbage, cauliflower, all of that family. And what it does is helps to pull the extra estrogens out of your liver. So you can use both of those to help cover both of your bases as well, in addition to all of these things, and watching how much of the plastics and things of that nature in your environment that could be affecting. Now, one other thing that I didn't mention with diet is if you're in perimenopause and you are vegan, vegetarian, you're using soy, you want to watch how much of soy you are using, because you can directly impact the amount of estrogens that you're intaking. Now, How much? It's individual. So it's crucial to get your hormone metabolism tested to know what in the heck is going on in this case, and then consider supplementing with diethylmethane, calcium D-glucurate to help you to further metabolize those hormones more effectively. My most favorite supplement in this case is a combination of diethylmethane and calcium D-glucurate that comes from a company called Orthomolecular. I'm not sponsored by that company whatsoever. I'm just mentioning it because it has both of the things that you would need if you're struggling with this. So if you're having trouble with your hormone metabolism and you want more information, I have a couple podcasts on this subject at the Health Fix podcast. You can go to my website, drjkrausnd.com, and get more information and resources as well to help you in your transition through perimenopause and menopause. I'm Dr. Janine Krause. Thanks for watching.